Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Dana Inglesby and I'm the department head in the Department of Applied Engineering here at JSU. Today I am going to be guiding you through a tutorial for using Schedule Planner. Schedule Planner is a tool that we use here at JSU to help students plan their schedules. I'm going to walk you through the process of Schedule Planner and then show you how to register for your courses. So let's get started. To start in Schedule Planner, you're going to log into your MyJSU account. Once you are on the main page for MyJSU, you will scroll down, and on the left-hand side, you should see the link for Schedule Planner. Click the link. We are going to be registering for the fall of 2020, but you'll select the appropriate semester for you, and then click Submit. Once you do this, you will be redirected to the Schedule Planner page. You will select all campuses and then save and continue. We're now in Schedule Planner, and the first thing that we're going to do is add courses to our schedule. I'm assuming that you have communicated with your advisor and you know what classes that you're supposed to take. Now you're going to start by clicking the red button that says Add Course. Now you may see before you get started that on the right-hand side your advisor has already preloaded some courses for you in Schedule Planner. If so, great. You don't have to select these courses. They've been selected for you. You may have some additional courses that you need to add in Schedule Planner, and I'm going to show you how to do that. But let's assume that we're starting with a blank slate and we need to add all of the courses to our schedule. The first course that I'm going to select is First Year Experience, which is STU 101. This course is required of all freshman students. STU and then 101, First Year Experience. Now I'm going to click the plus Add Course button, and that will add the course to my list of courses on the right-hand side. Now I'm going to add English, English 101. And here it is, English Composition 1. I'm going to add History. I'm going to add Math 112, and your Math and English course placement will depend on your Ed Ready test scores. So if you have not taken your Ed Ready test scores or you do not have ACT data on file with us here at JSU, you may not know what course to register for. See your advisor for more information about taking the Ed Ready tests. Finally, I'm going to add a science class to my schedule. I'm going to take biology. BY. And then I'm going to take Introductory Biology 1. This is the lecture portion of the science course. For almost every science course, you have a lecture and you have a lab. These are co-requisite courses. I must also take Biology 103, which is the corresponding lab to the Biology 101 lecture course. And I'm going to add that to the schedule. I now have all of my courses, and I'm going to go back and work towards generating the schedule after I add some breaks. The first break that I'm going to add to my schedule is lunch, so that I have a midday break each day to get something to eat between classes. That's going to be from 12 o'clock till 1 o'clock each day of the week. The next break that I'm going to add is work. So we'll add a work break from 7 a.m. until 10 a.m. on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Now, something I'm going to do to this break is add 15 minutes to the end of the break. The reason I'm doing this is because I don't want a class added to my schedule that starts at 10 a.m. I wouldn't have enough time to get from work to the class, and so I'm going to make my work break 15 minutes longer to allocate for the time that I would need to get to class. And I'm now going to add that break. So now I have all of my courses and I have my breaks added to the schedule, and now I can generate schedules by clicking the Generate Schedules button at the bottom. I'm going to view one of these schedules. I'll just view the first one. And now let's take a look at the schedule. So I've got my STU 101 class on Tuesday morning at 9:15. I've got biology lab on Thursday morning at 10. And then I have math and English on Monday and Wednesday afternoons, and then biology lecture on Tuesday, Thursday. This schedule looks really good to me. If there's something that you really like on the schedule, you can lock that particular class and then regenerate schedules so that you get options built around that class. That's an option too. So Schedule Planner is pretty flexible. I like this schedule, and so I'm going to add it to my shopping cart. And continue. Now I can register for these classes by clicking Register. So that concludes this video. In my next video, we'll talk about how to drop or add a class after you've already registered.